Operation Pigmentation sitting here talking a lot of football because we're recording this on a Sunday because we're not all going to be able to get together during the week. We're coming off Thanksgiving. I was talking to Laterian off the air, something that we didn't just cover here when we were going over everything. He did tell me that he appreciates that the Bears did fire their coach. Did anybody?
I appreciated that.
You did? Yeah. What'd you think about that? What'd you think about the way that whole game went down?
Well, I mean, I think that he shouldn't have been coaching to begin with.
That's right. Yes.
He shouldn't have never got the job. And then when they had a chance to fire him last year, they didn't.
Well, they're supposed to fire him this year, I guess, but then the ownership stepped in. They've just never fired a coach in, you know, their 100 and whatever years of being an organization.
Get over it.
Oh, well, it's over, baby. Yeah. It's over.
They fired his ass.
They're moving on. So that was a nice Thanksgiving treat. Anything wild happen to you guys? Any fights? Anybody get drunk and out of line? Anything worth bringing up, or we should just skip that?
You know the guy that walks around the neighborhood with a neck brace on?
No.
That's had it on for like the last 10 years?
No. Is he running a scam, or is he really injured?
I don't know what this is.
He's had it on for 10 years.
Right, okay.
Well, yesterday... He took it off, whooped the man's ass.
Choked him out.
Put it back on.
Shook his hand after he got done whooping his ass.
Got back on his bike,
put his neck brace on, and went home.
And pedaled off.
And you guys were just probably in amazement, like it was some sort of like David Copperfield trick,
actually,
right?
Actually, our good buddy Colton got a chance to witness all of that.
Colton's
Are you talking
on?
About Kenny?
Colton. No. Eric.
His name E.
E.
Yeah, Lee.
Do you know?
He stays
down the alley.
Off a knife?
Yeah.
Okay.
And he's been riding around on a bicycle.
Kenny the Dancing Man number two, right? By Salem's?
The younger one.
Oh, that's
with
not
the
him.
Blue hair. That's Kenny.
That's Kenny.
Yeah, that's Kenny. Right.
All right.
Yeah. Do you know about the man with the blue hair that dances on the corner set?
I don't know.
And paints murals. He draws them on a whiteboard, actually.
Which, what corner?
16th Street and 18th Avenue.
Okay.
Right there.
And this is a real person that has blue hair?
He has a blue wig.
Blue wig, okay.
He actually has dreadlocks.
Yeah.
I found out.
Something like that.
So what's his deal? Is he panhandling or is he...
I think it's just mental illness.
Yeah, it's mental illness like at its best.
And I think he's 34
or
5.
Yeah, he's in his 30s.
He's young. He's real young. My brother actually went to school with him.
And what's he doing? What's he doing on the corner? Like, is
whatever
he
the hell he there. Feels like doing, he lives on the corner.
He lives there.
Yeah,
you think I'm playing?
No, I don't.
Yeah,
he lives there. He might pull out a pillow, a comforter, and get on the
side.
He
had a whole house set up behind the post office right there on the corner in the cut.
It's not
they
bad,
got
right?
his ass from
with
over
a picket
there.
Fence and everything.
He had a picket fence and all set up in there.
A tent.
He had a little grill back there.
All that. He had made it a homestead.
You look up back there, he back there sweeping and shit.
Starting a garden.
What'd they do? Did the cops
the city of St. Pete and the police got his ass up out of there. You own fucking government property. And you got all this garbage back here set up and shit.
He like, made a picket fence.
That's the only thing, though. Because, like, if the city of St. Pete knows you, if you're, like, a known panhandler, the cops don't mess with them.
No, they don't mess with you if you
just
have
stay off private property.
When they started bothering him is when he had all of that garbage back there that he called his belongings and
with
shit.
A picket fence.
But
he literally made a white picket fence.
You got to get this shit out of here.
Why is it that homeless people, and I see them traveling with multiple shopping carts at times and stuff like that, 7 yards Jamar Chase, just so you know, Laterian just got seven. Why is it that why do you think they carry so much shit? Why are they not minimalists?
Why do they have two dogs?
Why do they have a dog anyway?
Well, a dog, listen, I can understand maybe having a companion, a little buddy.
No, that's another mouth. Well,
that's just a stray dog at the end of the day.
Look at my fucking owner. Look at my owner.
That's funny as hell, bro.
It's just a stray dog on a leash.
I trust homeless people with a companion more than the homeless person that doesn't have a companion.
Because at least it shows that they care. They might be more of like a real person instead of... alternative.
They just abuse the dog every time they get alone. God damn it, I'm homeless because of you.
Your ass shit. Homeless and the dog out here with you. You dragging the dog on. You could let the dog go.
He'll
be better off than you will.
It might be abuse. I just said I trust him more.
I just want to run away.
That's what's great about dogs, though, is that they don't judge. They're just happy to, you know, have.
No,
a
we assume that.
Yeah.
We assume that.
Oh no!
Ain't no way in hell that dog is happy to be homeless. Like, God damn it!
Maybe the dog.
Your
is
ass
just,
homeless. I'm homeless.
Maybe we finna walk happy, over here again.
Maybe the dog is happy just to be with you. You ever thought
I'm
about
tired
that?
Of walking.
No. Not you and homeless.
Can you feed me? Are you going to feed me today, Tony?
Yeah.
Tony, are you feeding me?
Yeah.
Homeless Tony.
So,
like, how is
so we
both
can say
homeless?
We can say if they both homeless and they're older and they've been on the streets for a while, the dog ultimately trusts.
No, he has mental illness.
Okay, there it is.
Yeah, the dog fucked just, up it, like
it,
you.
It just stops right
both
there.
Fucked up.
Oh, counseling.
Shit.
What do you want the dog? What should the dog do? Just in the middle of the night?
I think the dog should haul ass.
Gone? And just
God
fucking
damn
what?
It.
No, I think
should
the dog.
Should it meet up with some other dog or just
I'm
hope
a
they get adopted?
Dog.
I think the dog should maul
if
his
If my
ass.
Master is homeless, that counts me as a stray dog.
Hey, Jamar, just saved my parlay,
I
baby.
I saw 50 yards. Congrats.
Thank you, Seth.
Thank you.
Laterian's got a big-time parlay going, including
Baker. Homeless Tony is getting mauled.
Homeless Tony's getting
yeah,
my dog. By his dog.
I'm just... There are people that enjoy
four
being
leg,
homeless, maybe.
Added two other props.
I believe that a lot of people enjoy being homeless.
Right.
It's a choice.
Because this is only in America that this is a problem.
We talked about that.
Yeah.
Well, if people can enjoy it, maybe dogs enjoy it, too.
No. Fuck no.
Not having to be crate trained and shit, just living out
Man,
there
I
in the
would
streets.
Love to have a dog bowl.
No. He definitely wants a bowl. Fresh water and shit.
Yeah.
Fleas and shit. The
right.
Fuck, Tony? I
he
know the
got
dog
fleas,
like look
the
at
owner
that.
Got fleas. They passing fleas back
How about
and forth
this?
And
How about,
shit.
Tony, you don't never get me none. And yeah. You don't get none.
Oh, you're worried about you're now the dog
that
is mad
dog
at the owner
wanna,
for not getting sex?
The dog wanna fuck
the dog. The dog natural instinct is to reproduce.
Yeah.
I mean and, like,
that's what his purpose in life is.
Tony got the dog humping everything he get close to.
Dog horny than a motherfucker, man. Poor dog. That's what I'm saying. The dog better off just being a stray dog.
My dogs, I mean, but if you have a dog at home, you're not taking your dog to fuck. I mean, your dog, I mean.
But that's different. The dog's at home. The dog's not homeless.
So you're saying the streets make dogs hornier?
Yeah, yeah.
Well, no, I'm
dog
just saying.
Dog just humping the golf cart.
I know.
A stray dog gets more pussy
bang,
than
bang,
a homeless
bang, bang,
dog
bang. Sound like when you run into a chain fence. Dog just going ham on the golf cart.
The homeless dog, he ain't got a lot to worry about.
Right.
The stray dog, he out there.
That's right.
Yeah.
He's getting pussy hand over fist.
Oh, he can just walk around.
He can fuck any dog he want to.
Now, but he also takes the chance of, you know, getting picked up and then, you know, getting put down if someone doesn't adopt him. You know, that's what happens too when you get loose.
But he gonna run away from the dog.
Yeah, that only happens to pit bulls.
Okay. So all right, this is very interesting, man.
The rest of the dogs, they run free.
Yeah,
talking about homeless dogs and if they get pussy, I am telling you guys.
Hey, guess what? Man, guess
if anybody else is talking about that,
Operation Pigmentation. No one's talking about
that.
No
one's talking about that.
That's right. Yeah. And we should talk
and
about
this
it more.
This is a legitimate
concern.
This debate.
Yeah,
a conversation.
Well, yeah, and you know what?
Because everybody has dogs.
And everybody knows homeless Kenny.
And
everybody know him.
Let me just bring this back because you guys. I want to just slow the story down. I want to break it down. You know, John Madden style. There's been a man with a neck brace for 10 years. Did anybody ask any questions about the neck brace? Or it just was...
I was around when it actually got put on. He was in an accident.
Okay.
Around the corner from the house.
All right.
One of the friends, they helped pull him out the car. And
was he like, fucked up?
I mean, day or two after that, he had the neck brace on. That was in 2016. He still has the neck brace on.
It's 2025.
It's 2025.
So,
I know that thing stank.
So did you see the whole thing go down? Did you only catch it like?
Well, we caught him in the middle of him whooping ass.
Okay.
Yeah.
And I thought it was somebody else because you know it was kind of down the street, so you couldn't really see. Plus, like it's been 10 years since we seen him without a neck brace.
Right.
On.
Right.
So we really didn't know who the hell.
Yeah.
That
we
did
didn't
he
know.
Have tan lines? Was
we
he like fucking white?
Well, it was so
there?
Far away.
Okay.
They were like across the street,
yeah,
so you could see. And like Colton, like I said, he got a chance to get it up. He live and in person. He was right there. And he was like, if I wasn't here to see this, I would not have believed that that would happen.
Did he beat
I'm
he
glad
beat his...
Colton experienced that.
That's what it's
now, like. Now he's a living witness, like,
this
shit not bullshit.
Yeah, this right. really goes on in the hood. He watched this man whoop this man ass, get back on his bicycle and put his neck brace on.
And ride off into the sunset.
Ride off into the sunset.
And he shook the man's hand, too?
Yes. Yeah.
After he choked the man after almost to death.
Right.
Yeah, he had the man in a chokehold while he gave him a speech.
He just slammed and picked him up with his feet off the ground and slammed
body
him on the ground.
Body slammed him,
WWF. Yeah. And then, you know, explained to him why I whooped your ass.
Yeah.
Shook his hand. Got on his bike.
And then said, somebody hand me my neck brace. Somebody hand me my neck brace.
And when we seen him put on the neck brace, that's when we knew who it was.
Oh, that's
like,
E.
Oh, shit.
That's E.
This bitch really is crazy. Because everybody know he nuts.
Man, that's a good. And
he likes to fight.
Or he loves fighting.
Well, Taryn and JD, does stuff like this, like, does that pique your interest? Or is that, you know, just another day as far as stories like that?
I'm not surprised because of how I grew up in a barbershop. So, like, I'm not surprised. I remember, like, a long time ago, it was some crackheads, like, a couple of days before Christmas fighting over some change in the parking lot. Dead ass, bro.
And this happens. This is normal.
So you got a good view, basically, of any fight that goes down. I mean, you guys, you know, through all those windows there, you can catch it for, you know, anything that's around.
Man, we've seen some hoes pull up one time.
Oh, yeah.
And next thing you know, it's a whole melee out there in the parking lot. Wigs and titties flying everywhere.
It was big girls.
There was some biggins.
Eight big girls pulled up.
Why'd they meet in that parking lot?
I don't know.
Because the girls who they were jumping on,
yeah,
they was getting that, but the little boy was getting a haircut.
Oh, no.
And they found that hoe. They said,
they
we caught
like,
this
that bitch.
Bitch
at the barbershop.
You guys are getting caught up in this shit, man.
No, no, that happened
That was outside.
And one of them was fighting with the baby in her hands.
Okay.
Oh, yeah. She had the baby in her hand getting it in, swinging with the other hand.
Yep.
Bitch.
Yep. And after it was all over, everybody jumped in their cars and left.
Disappeared like nothing happened.
But then one of the crews came back to get their fingernails and eyelashes.
Wig,
eyelashes, and fingernails.
Hey, just imagine them. They in the car all freaked
and then,
out.
Hold on.
We can't go back. They probably got cameras.
Hold on, T. I'm getting a phone call from the customer.
I paid $300
for that
wig.
I'm sorry. Them girls, I didn't know they was going to come up there. Mm. Girl.
Is you all right?
It was a lot of beef out there.
Yes, goodness. Like, it was at least 1200 pounds.
Royal Rumble.
I knew it. I knew it.
A lot of cattle out there.
Did anybody see? Yeah, all right.
Felt like a bunch of freight trains
just moving. Imagine if you was the little kid.
The polar kid. He was hanging on.
Yeah, no, he's fucked.
In the middle of the fight.
Yeah.
How does he recover from that?
He doesn't. Yeah,
he doesn't.
He's got to be on a medicine they haven't invented yet.
Mama, you remember Mama?
Oh, no.
She'll be like, no, what you talking about?
No, she's going to be wondering why he always is fighting. It's because this is an example.
Right.
Oh, no, he going to be like 15, and when he get ready to fight, he go and jump on his mama's side and put his hands, legs around her hips, and then he ready to fight.
He's like a kangaroo in a pouch.
Is that the polite way to fight, though, is to just, you know, choke somebody out, you end it, when they're on the ground, not, you know, jump on them and shit and, like, you know, walk your separate ways? Is that the best way for a street fight to end?
If you got built up fucking anger, if you're a fucking man, if you're a man,
like,
let's fight fist to fist. If you lose, see ya.
That's it. There shouldn't be nothing after that.
Okay. No gunplay.
Yeah. You got your ass whooped.
You know what a lot of gunplay comes from? Younger people can't take a loss.
Right. It's damaging to their ego.
Yeah. What it is, they can't take a loss with dignity.
Hey, guess what?
Indifferent.
Learn how to fight.
Indifferent.
You think?
I mean.
Or stop being an asshole to where people want to fight you.
Straight up.
Yes.
Yeah.
Or,
shut your fucking mouth.
Or with the culture we see today, when somebody fights trying to fight one-on-one, what happens?
A lot of jumping.
Okay. Boom. They jump in. I don't have time to get fucking jumped when I agree to a one-on-one fight. And then
there are no rules.
And if I do lose,
there are no rules.
I done shook this man's hand saying, all right, we going to stop. And he curb stomping me because I'm knocked out.
See?
You see, that's why I don't even take it there with nobody, because I take it to the next point.
I'm not going to stop.
Yes. See? Right here. This is what I'm talking about right here.
I have rage.
You see this
Steph.
Shit?
I was going to say something about
that. I have rage.
You need to get it out?
Like, I feel like fights
No, I don't get it out, but if I feel like I got the we and you finna try to hurt each other, I'm like really, really intent on fucking you up.
I was going to say that. It depends on what the other person got going on, too, because like if they got some built-up trauma and shit, you probably going to... You might lose your life.
Do you think that we're meant to fight in life? Because what is it after you fight somebody that like makes you like you're cool with them, right? I mean, I don't want to say all the time, not if you're getting fucking jumped, but
when you have somebody that's around you and they need to stand up for themselves, and then you know you keep fucking with them, and they finally fight back.
Yes,
that's like a win for them, and you be like, finally, this motherfucker fought back. My job is done here. And you move on to bully somebody else.
So
till you meet your match.
I wanted to talk to you guys about, I got a few things down here, but one of them is, have you guys seen any of the videos of people that were trying to deep fry their turkeys? And do you guys enjoy watching people risk their lives in order to do that? I found myself being fascinated with reels of people lowering that fucking thing in there, man. Yeah. Like they're going to, like, you know, try to cut a wire of a bomb.
That's the equivalent to somebody getting bit by an alligator in Florida.
Are you guys
the same level of
I can't
excitement.
Turn away.
Is it stupidity, or do you guys enjoy, like, deep-fried turkeys? Is that something that you can
do?
No,
I mean,
I love. I like fried turkey, personally.
But just because it's an idea, don't make it a good one.
Yeah. It's a lot of work.
If you don't make yourself knowledgeable, you probably going to fuck.
You're going to be one of those reels.
Yeah. You're going to start a fire, burn your house down.
Complete
drop
idiot.
A whole fucking 2 gallons of grease on yourself.
Right. That's
somebody had a pot filled to the brim
to the
and then
brim
finna drop
and
a turkey,
put a turkey
in an open
idiot.
Fucking flame. Dumb. Like,
and then the guy had to go in, and he was going in with like a fucking thing, like scooping out like the oil and shit, like as the turkey's like halfway in there, man. I just go, it's just not worth it. What to me, it's not worth it.
He should have pulled that turkey out.
Well, he should have did a little more
preparation.
Did you know there's a line inside of that big pot that says fill line?
You don't supposed to put grease past that line.
It's right there.
It's for a reason.
Yeah.
It's all right. So you guys talked about this, and it actually leads into to something that I wanted to get into. You talked about, you know, kids these days, and that the reason why they get guns is like they're not able to, you know, take a loss, and it's a
they're pussies.
Pussies. Okay,
they're pussies. Let's just call it what it is.
Then let's talk about what happened in fucking college football this weekend.
Oh boy.
Oh yeah. Michigan, Ohio State,
everywhere.
All them bitches been fighting. That's because these guys are fucking pussies.
Bottom line.
Who's the two of the pussies? The winners, the losers,
the
everybody?
Both of them. They're all pussies. Everybody's pussies. You got sore losers and sore winners, and everybody can't take it, and the only thing they can do is fight.
So if somebody chooses not to fight and use their words and try to calm down the situation, he's a loser
too.
You
stupid.
Too.
No.
See, look, you can't win nowhere.
He's winning.
You can't win nowhere.
No, he needs to do that later. He can't do that during the melee.
No, I'm not talking about him trying to stop a fight.
Oh,
fuck all that. That's the police job.
No,
I'm talking about me and another person are having an argument. And this person's trying to take it there. And I'm trying to use everything I got with words and just like backing away from the situation.
You should have just went home.
See, and
I
do. I
mean, once it comes
on
to a point where you see that you're fucking arguing with idiocy.
And you try to leave.
And then if he touch you, you beat the shit out of his ass.
Yeah.
You got the green light to beat the tar off his ass.
Yeah, because he's stupid.
Why did his voice?
Because
if he touch you, he said that. I felt that. You got every
right.
Because
you tried to handle it civilly. You cannot make an excuse for ignorance and stupidity.
Yeah. Straight up.
You can't.
What is it with this flag planting bullshit? Like, it seems that it's the absolute peak of insanity, and it makes me actually embarrassed to be a sports fan. I'm not talking, I mean, even the guy, like, you're fighting over a fucking flag that they're putting on fucking grass. Like, it doesn't mean shit.
If you'd have whooped their ass, they wouldn't have put no fucking flag on your shit. You're mad because they've been beating your ass 4 years in a row.
The principal, no. But as a sports, like, player person, your feelings fucking hurt, right? You got all this testosterone. You've been playing for four quarters, and we ain't winning the game. We gonna win the brawl. You know what I'm saying? So I understand that, and it is disrespectful, but the older they just gotta mature.
Get over it.
Yeah. They gotta win.
Be their ass. You win. With the number two team in the country, and you was at home.
It wasn't. Win. And by the way, it wasn't just Michigan and Ohio State yesterday.
It was other teams.
Yeah,
Florida State got into
man,
it.
Well, it's. I'm telling you, it's the
Florida
holiday.
State
They've been fighting
just, they
since
won
Thursday
no games all damn
all year.
Yeah. NFL.
Florida State
was like, fuck it. We done lost. We ain't got no more games. We finna whoop their ass.
Straight
fuck
up,
that.
We gonna make Sports Center somehow.
We so, gonna get on TV.
Took Florida minus 11 yesterday.
They covered, didn't they?
Yes, sir.
It was a good bet.
Do you guys think that it was a good use of mace when they busted out?
Nothing delivers the comfort and joy like the unrivaled quality and taste of Omaha Steaks. It's guaranteed perfection in every single bite. And right now you can save on unforgivable gifts with 50% off site-wide at omahasteaks.com. Plus, score an extra $30 off with promo code ARMY. A-R-M-Y. With five generations of experience, they consistently deliver the world's best steak experience. And the gifting experts at Omaha Steaks have made it easy to deliver the perfect gift with their thoughtfully curated gift packages featuring gourmet favorites. As a matter of fact, I just sent my dad this very same package. From legendary steaks to mouth-watering desserts and more, save 50% off site-wide for a limited time only at omahasteaks.com. Plus, my listeners get an extra $30 off with promo code ARMY. That's 50% off at omahasteaks.com. O-M-A-H-A steaks.com. And an extra $30 off with promo code ARMY. Minimum purchase may apply.
Okay.
Yeah, I think that was deserved.
Okay, because some people were saying that they should have done that. And I was like, if you got
For
all
what?
These football.
You got to stop these idiots from doing
right,
this
Right, you
shit.
Got these fucking 300-pound men that are pretty much in armor. And you're just a fucking cop. Yep. Like,
and
they're
in
tase?
Full shape.
Yeah, I mean, what are you going to. You can't tase them through their shit. Like, you got to fucking
in a situation like that, mace is the correct thing to do.
You know, and see, the thing with mace is you can spray it on one little area and everybody's affected around.
I was just about to say that. Somebody got in a fight when I worked at the shoe store, and they came back and they came to get they get back and they sprayed mace. We had to shut down the whole fucking store.
Yeah.
Now, I know Charleston White carries around mace. Do you think that
he carries bear mace?
Bear mace.
He's diabolical.
Do you think I should start carrying that shit around?
No.
No.
Do you have anybody
you
that wants to attack you?
No. It, well, yeah. I mean,
you get sued for that.
Have you been beat up?
No. But
I don't believe
spray
that you
yourself.
Need.
Well, I'm not like a gun guy or anything like that.
You gonna fuck around and spray
so
yourself.
I don't believe
it'd
be necessary
Steph gonna be
for you
like
to
Cheddar
have that.
Bob, wait, man.
You gonna be like Cheddar Bob. You gonna shoot your goddamn self.
Wait, if I asked you guys if I should get a gun, you'd all say yeah. But now I ask you guys if I should get bear mace, and it's a big no.
Well, yeah, you. What the fuck are you? You're not gonna
fuck somebody up if they get in my shit.
You're gonna fuck yourself.
You
up.
Don't need to be. You got to be in close proximity to use the mace. You know.
Well, I thought it could get 60 to 80 feet range.
Yeah, but
it's got a little range on it.
Like the gun's a little more effective. What if the mace don't work?
Here's the thing.
He's still gonna come and kick your ass.
What if he licks the mace like it just tastes good?
I'll go down spraying
bear mace. Bear mace.
Yeah, he's just like
that's like I told my little cousin in damn prison.
So hard.
My cousin say. Because he a little soft, and I was like, you not made for prison. And he was like, oh, motherfucker, try me. I'm going to whoop their ass and all this other shit. And I'm like, he like this big. He's fucking damn 90 pounds soaking wet. But then I was like, okay, so Big Tookie come out the cut.
This nigga.
You know what I mean? You know, you going to eat your cornbread. Man, he like, nigga, you goddamn right, I'm going to eat my cornbread. I say, well, what you going to do to get Big Tookie off you? And he was like, I'm going to put a motherfucking lock in the sock. And I was like, well, for shits and giggles, let's just say they do you somehow get a lock. In prison, because ain't nobody getting no locks in prison.
Right, right.
It's a weapon.
But let's just say you get one, and you got your sock, and Big Tookie coming, and you swinging that bitch like the terrible towel, and you crack him across his fucking damn skull.
And he just eats that.
And he wiped the blood off his face and say, oh, I like it rough. What you gonna do then? Because you just gave it everything you got. What are you going to do? Your next move should be to bend over.
Oh, fuck, man. That's a bad. Those are bad options, man.
Well, those are your only options.
All right, so get this. If you use bear mace on a person, you can be arrested and sued. That's why I was like, nah, don't use bear mace. Go get you some regular mace.
All right, regular mace. I'll do regular mace.
Yeah, don't.
You don't need any mace at all.
Charleston White got money to get sued, so that's right. Why he carrying bear mace.
But I got nothing. That's why it's even better.
It's like when you go somewhere and show up at a public event, no one's going to be talking about kicking your ass.
No, but
nobody's dropping your location.
You never know, though, who could want to
fucking
take
somebody wants to kick. Charlton's White's ass.
Absolutely.
There's a lot of people want to kick his ass.
But I just found it to be a unique style of defense that I was looking to get into, especially
what are you defending yourself against?
Just the elements, man. I think 2025 is going to be a rough and tumble year. So, I mean,
I have 100% confidence that none of that's coming your way.
Okay, I mean, you don't ever hear about, there's gun violence at schools. You don't hear about mace violence at schools.
Seth.
Well, you're not going to school.
I have a card for you that we walk around with it. I think it'll help you out.
What's the card?
It's just a card. I'm going to give it to you after the show, okay?
Oh, shit. Okay. Is it?
Hey, Seth, I used to go to a club in Tampa.
Yeah, Craig.
I used to go to a club in Tampa, and when the club let out, that's how they got everybody out the club.
What happened? What'd they do?
Tampa police walked around and sprayed mace on the floor. Literally.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, that's how you knew it was over.
I just saw people that were complaining that they couldn't believe the cops used mace yesterday and that, you know, got some reporters and all this shit. But I mean, you want to get in the middle of that mix. I mean,
You got 60 grown men with equipment and helmets on, throwing helmets and fists, fighting.
Mind you, the stadium holds 110,000 people.
What if they decide to join?
We need to get this shit under control right now.
Right now.
Right now.
Yeah.
Would that be a brawl or a riot?
That's a riot.
I think that would be an all-out war.
Yeah. I think it was
100,000 people.
That's bigger than
that's
a mosh
a couple
pit.
Troops and shit.
It's funny because you look at the Malice in the Palace from back in the day with Ron Artest and all that shit like that. But I mean, this was yesterday, there was at least, you know, 12 of these things where people were fucking, you know, going at it in the middle of the field or on the sidelines or just a bunch of shit. They were talking about the coach of Nebraska, Matt Rhule, saying that he walked through, you know, a team's warm-up and something like that. Then his team refused to shake Iowa's hand. I mean, it's just a bunch of fucking petty nonsense, man.
It's all psych.
But you also
got to
remember
wars.
The reason why all of this pettiness is now really, really high is because these motherfuckers getting paid now.
Yeah.
And now, I can act the ass. I can do whatever the rules don't.
I don't even. I don't have to go to the NFL to make money.
No, I can just make a spectacle out of college.
They're making millions of dollars. These people, and there's people paying these kids. So I'm outraged. You sprayed my fucking player with goddamn mace. That was totally unnecessary.
That's right, because he needs to sell cars.
Right. He can't fucking damn
see. He can't
sell
cars another day in his life.
See.
You feel me?
How's he gonna sell my cars?
I've seen a security guard desk pop in a venue to calm a crowd down.
Have you?
He just popped ill during Super Bowl weekend.
If Florida State would have won last night, and at the end of the game, if that Indian would have went out there and threw that spike, threw that spear,
Chief Osceola?
They were at Dope Campbell.
Yeah, they was in Dope.
But if he would have came out and done that, would they have beat the horse and the man up?
Yeah,
it probably would have been some animal. Somebody was drunk enough, and they just would have wanted to do it anyways.
Yeah,
it was going to be some animal.
I'm going to knock out the horse.
Somebody was going to literally try to kill that horse.
Bet me $100 I can knock the horse.
I got to tell you, they should be...
I'll parlay that.
They're going to be pretty close to not allowing live animal mascots on the sidelines because one of them's going to get hurt or injured. I don't know if it's going to be a tiger, a fucking pit bull, whatever it is, but...
It's going to be one of those lazy Georgia dogs.
You think that's going to get
one of the motherfuckers already tried to bite a bitch before. They got it on film. That motherfucker, he's a little mean little dog. Ugga.
Yeah, he is ugly too.
Little fucker.
The one from Georgia?
That's his name, Ugga. It's Ugga like 8 now. It's like 8 renditions of his
ass. Yeah, they got to get him. Do you guys think that because it seems like it's no big deal once the game's over to just go, and we'll move on after this, but to go and plant the flag, do you think that the person that does that should be suspended for the next game just to quell that?
No, that's just sports culture. That's
what they've been doing.
But it's not a good
look. It's just televised now, bro.
Guys, but it's not a good look when people are seeing when business owners are seeing the players they're investing in that are fucking slapping each other around after, you know, these hard-fought games or these huge upsets. Like, nobody wants to see that. Nobody's like, man, what happened yesterday? We need to see more of that, especially when you're talking about the kids that are getting paid. Maybe they feel, you know, more entitled or more freedom to go ahead and do that because they got some extra cash.
I think that it should be instead of them keep on treating it as amateur sports. In amateur sports, we all shake hands after the game.
Yes.
In professional sports, you don't do that.
You shake with whoever you want to.
And you don't, but they get off the fucking court and they go the fuck on their ways because they're getting paid.
The marshals handle the coaches after that.
And they
the major players, the marshals handle them, and then after that.
Look at the NFL. I mean, you know, they'll come out and some people are going there, the coaches go and slap hands, some of the players will come. But if it's a real rivalry team, like a real rivalry game, they're going straight to after the coaches pat hands, everybody's leaving. Everybody's going to the locker rooms. I don't like them. We don't
Seth,
like y'all.
When
fuck
I coached
y'all.
Little League football, this was the listen.
You
after
guys
the
had
game,
flags?
After the game, the League, this is what we have to do after the game. Oh, after the game, after we win, you guys, no helmets come off, and we run to the bus.
That was standard protocol for your team.
Depends on where we were at.
Yeah. Yeah.
Straight why, were up. Would parents or kids try to riot? Or
both.
It's just
everybody.
Shit, man.
Like when we would play like Greenwood or something
oh,
like
yeah,
that.
Oh, yeah, we run into the bus.
You get your ass whooped.
Greenwood, Palmetto.
If they lose, they're not going to lose the fight. So after the game, everybody, we're not hanging out. We're not watching any
and
of the games.
And
we're
not slapping hands.
We out.
Yeah, hurry up and get the fuck on.
Man, when they go to 000, we run to the bus.
Much like they talk about how, you know, teams have to learn to win and guys have to learn to win, you got to learn how to lose, right? I mean, because that shouldn't be your reaction, is that you want to go kick somebody's ass.
No. I think they really should start treating it as professional sports. Y'all don't need to fucking shake hands. Get the fuck off the field. Go to your locker room. Game's over.
Should the coaches, though? I mean, coaches set a good example and shake?
Nope.
They just go on their separate ways?
I mean, if it's a rivalry like Michigan involved, and Ohio State. But let's just keep
if
this shit
like
down
you,
cordial. Yeah, keep
if
it
I
cordial.
Don't like you,
we won. Y'all lost.
Yeah, yo
see
bad.
You next year.
See you next year.
See you next year. We'll do it again.
If you want to talk to me, beat me.
Period. All right. I mean, like Ohio State. If you go to Ohio State, you don't even say the word Michigan. You refer to the school up north.
Well, they don't even use. They don't even type out M. They won't even use M.
Yeah, the week of the game, they say they're Michigan. Not using. Yeah. They, I mean,
so
this
fucking stupid.
So
man.
When
it
is that deep,
in the blood.
When it's that deep,
come on.
What
man.
Are we shaking hands for after the game? There is no reason
in
to
Brompton.
Shake hands.
We in
let's stop that, y'all. There's marshals escort this team that way. Marshals escort that team the other way.
I want to pray for everybody after the game.
That's nice too. There are some teams that, you know, will get together for a little prayer circle. You know,
that's fine.
Yeah, I want to do that.
Remember that used to be a bigger deal in the NFL. Like, I don't. I feel like Russell Wilson used to lead some big ass prayer circles, and now
they tried to usher that out of the league.
They
don't want that.
They don't want any. They don't want anybody getting on a knee anymore.
Well, they I mean, all the religious and the taking the knees and all that other shit. They're trying to really get away from all of that because that opens the door up for all kind of other bullshit.
Right. Which they've been dealing with for a long time.
Yeah. That's right. We just want y'all to play football.
All right.
Just play some football.
Bro. Rio, the reason we're doing this podcast today is because you're going to be in Dayton because you're going to see your grandmother.
Yeah.
And you're giving your grandmother your dad's ashes.
Right.
And so I didn't even know this, man, but there was a podcast we did a couple of weeks ago, and you texted me afterwards that your dad had passed that day, and I had no fucking idea. And, you know, you were talking about, you know, how you know, therapeutic it is to do this podcast and everything. What happened with your dad? And I mean, how are you doing?
It was, I'm doing fine, but, he basically, how do I put it? His lifestyle and the way he lived his life ultimately ended his life.
Okay.
And, just that's like why they kind of tell you, you know, what you're doing now is preparing you. Your future, you is dependent on you. So, you know, he did a lot of things to his in his life to mess up his body. And when it was time to, you know, for his body to kick in and start helping him, he wasn't strong enough to do so.
Now, oh, man.
Yeah. And that's why the doctors, when the doctors tell you to do something, like, do it, you know. And it really stemmed from something really simple. He broke his leg, like, in 2018.
Really?
Yeah.
And then what happened from there?
Well, he was overweight. And basically what the doctor was saying is, bro, you need to lose some weight so that we can fix your leg so that when it grows back, right, you know, and the bone goes back, and everything will be right. But we can't do the surgery until you lose some weight. And he chose not to and actually pushed the issue even more. And they finally did the surgery, but then what was that, septic, whatever that shit is.
Oh, yeah, yeah, yeah.
That started, and then it just, he could never recover from it.
Was he local? Did he live here?
Yeah, he did. He was in Tampa the last 8 years.
How is your, how's your grandma holding up?
Hey, she's 90 years old, man.
Is she,
she's
still
cool. doing she's her thing. Cooler than a fan.
Is she okay? So what are you, what is, are you taking any of your dad's asses? You just, are you turning them over to her?
Yeah, I'm giving her the whole urn.
Her whole thing, okay.
Yeah.
Does he want to, did he want them like?
Yeah, this is, no, he wanted me to take his ashes back home.
Okay.
He was born in Dayton, Ohio.
Okay.
He's from there. So it was like, you know, he wanted to cremate. He didn't want us spending a whole ton of money on a funeral service. And he was like, when you get done, take my ashes home. And that's what I'm doing.
Well, I appreciate that you're doing that, man. And I wanted to make sure that we got a podcast in since, you know, it's not like you just were, you know, we're going out of town or some bullshit. Like,
right.
You know, you got something serious to do. I know one of my friends was tasked one time with spreading his dad's ashes at the Braves. What was it? Turner Field? What was it? Whatever their stadium was before this one.
Mm-hmm. That's Turner Field.
Turner Field. Yeah. Yeah, they his dad wanted his ashes spread there. So they had to fuck. First of all, you're smuggling in the ashes in a bag because you can't bring an urn or anything into a baseball game.
Yeah, yeah.
And so then you're taking the bag, which God knows what look, you know, kind of drug it looks like these days. And you're running down to, you know, like the foul, you know, foul ground or something like that. You know, dump it out there real quick. So
and it, dude. Have you ever experienced a urn or ashes from a cremation?
But as far I have, yes.
That's a lot of fucking ashes. You're gonna look really fucking suspicious with a bag full of ashes. That's a lot of ashes. It's not like it's a handful.
Like, it's
and that urn is heavy as shit. Yeah. That urn is every bit of 25-30 pounds.
I think that's when you split up, you know, the ashes, everybody gets a little bit, and then, you know, somebody, may you spread me here, you spread me there, so.
I think that's fucking disgusting.
Well,
it's crazy how on, like, movies they portray urns to be so small. And ashes,
though.
We're just passing it around on the couch.
When they handed that bitch to me, I was like, holy shit, this bitch heavy.
Rio, are the ashes, like, your carry-on, or how you getting those?
You actually have to go to the funeral home and get some paperwork to travel with this shit.
Okay.
You can't travel with an urn unless you have this paperwork that's from the state of Florida letting everybody know this is what you got in these goddamn urns.
Because they want to make sure you're not smuggling cocaine or anything like
that. Or maybe a bomb on the plane, you know.
Yeah.
They don't want you doing that, but
Don't forget, cocaine is herbal.
Oh, my gosh.
It does come from a plant. It comes from a plant.
JD let us know last podcast that cocaine is herbal.
So, Rio, so you got a fuck ton of ashes on your hands?
Yep.
Okay. Well, listen, man, I'm sorry about what happened to your dad. You got to seem to have a good attitude about it, and I think it's honorable that you're going and, you know, delivering on his wish and, you know, taking the 102 pounds of ashes
right, dude.
To his mom. Just be what
man.
The fuck? Poor boy. Yeah,
you got. Do you think people
man gets caught in the ashes?
And it's like 23 degrees up there.
Oh, beautiful.
Man gets caught with 3 kilos of heroin.
In an urn.
In an urn. Come to find out it wasn't heroin.
What was your question, Laterian?
I was just saying essentially that. Like, do you think, why is it so hard? Why do you got to get all that paperwork? Like, you think, like, somebody selling ashes on the black market or something?
Yeah, that's
when
going
I went
down.
To go and do when we went to do the funeral arrangements, they was informing us that it's going to take, like, a week for them because they have to let the state know that they're finna cremate a body.
Yeah,
and the state has to approve it.
Yeah,
and
yeah.
It's a lot going on with that, but it's a lot of paperwork that has to be filed. And yeah,
I was saying why I know they make it hard. I understand why, yeah. But. What do they think somebody going? Yeah, I'm about to go sell these ashes for like $50,000 in Bitcoin.
Well, you
like,
know, they fucking freak out if you bring some shampoo on the plane. So, yeah. I mean, you know, you see.
If you bring an aerosol can, they will have a fucking damn fit in the line.
Yeah, in the airport.
In TSA.
Oh, yeah.
So was. Oh,
throwing
I know that.
That shit away.
So was the paperwork you got to travel, was that specifically to fly or even just drive?
I would probably say specifically to fly.
Okay, that's what I was at.
Like, in the event that you got pulled over or driving, I'm pretty sure you would want to show that paperwork because the police gonna want to know what's in that urn.
And by the time, yeah, they test
and
it and do all that, you're gonna be in jail.
Well, it's not like it's a twist off cap. This thing is sealed shut. So U.S. is you got to break this urn to get in.
Oh man!
And I'm pretty sure the police is willing to bust it wide open.
Bro, yeah. Imagine.
Like, hold on, man.
Imagine what type of lawsuit that is if they accidentally.
Yeah, this is your
we
dad.
Thought it was drugs. You just sprayed my dad across the interstate.
He just bust my
he
dad.
He just flew
open.
Across the highway.
You son of a bitch.
Yeah, sure, good. That's not your
you
dad.
You fucking pig.
That's not your dad. Sure, those are rib ashes.
See, and there's a dude on the internet right now that got pulled over with his daughter's ashes and a little I don't know what to call it.
It's like a locket or something
locket.
Was he black? Was he black?
Yes, he was.
Oh, okay.
And they confiscated it, tested it. The cop was like, it tested positive for like methamphetamine or whatever the case. He was like, what? He was like, you tested my daughter, bro. And it was a whole debacle after that.
Yeah, because your daughter was on meth.
Yeah, Holy shit, man. That's crazy.
What if the cop said that to that man?
Yeah.
I don't care what you say. Your daughter was on meth.
That would be.
Do you know that those tests on the side of the road are like 80% wrong all the time?
Yes.
They test positive all the time for substances that are nowhere near what they say they are.
That's why they say don't do those, but then you get your license automatically suspended or something like that.
It doesn't
right?
matter. You can do all of that, and bottom line is you need to call our lawyer and get it taken care of.
And it's so crazy because they even have packets where they don't even open them like to put in the substance, and they just break them. And they test positive.
Yep.
Mm-hmm.
Crazy. With nothing in it.
With nothing but a sealed container, it tests positive.
Yeah, because regardless, if we pull this out, you're going to jail.
Pretty much.
I love the way you said
it. Yeah, you're going to jail. Have you ever heard somebody say, yeah, man, I went to jail. I'd be like, bro, you did not go to jail. You got taken
the jail.
To jail. Yeah.
Yeah, you guys taught me about that. Yeah, no one goes to jail.
No one goes to jail.
No, it's like I'm not going Black Friday shopping at jail.
Yeah, I'm not going there because guess what? Big Tookie is there.
Big Tookie waiting on you.
Yeah, waiting on you.
Big Tookie and the sock and the lock ain't going to take care of
he's
Big Tookie, okay?
That's what? He's going to use that blood for lube.
Oh, my God. Mm-hmm. I got to go.
That's going in you.
All right. It's
he's going
Rio,
in you.
I just
like you.
Rio,
I gotta have you.
Good luck. I just wanted to say you carrying a fucking shit ton of ashes in an urn to Dayton, Ohio in 23 degrees, sloshing through the snow, carrying those ashes. It seems like it's an Eddie Murphy movie. Like, if he hears about this story, I feel like, he's setting the tone for some sort of comedy, man. Good luck with everything. Thanks for coming in here. Guys, I know we got to go watch some fucking football, so, we're done talking.
Football.
Let's do it. Letarian's got his fucking parlays. He needs 12 rushing yards from Baker Mayfield. JD is not a degenerate, so I don't think he has any parlays in here.
He's a degenerate.
He's a degenerate.
He's sweating one, right?
We got two degenerates and two potheads.
Listen, I just hit.
You got four potheads.
Four potheads. Yeah.
Well, five.
Oh, five potheads.
Yeah.
All right. Yeah. Guess what? All OP family have great holidays, everybody. It's the holiday season, everybody.
It
let's
is.
Have fun. Let's yeah, make it man. Let's make it wonderful.
All right. Thanks, guys. Great job.
All right, Bubba.
Peace.
Peace, guys.
That was wonderful.
I know I'm getting out of here, man. Don't be surprised if you see me run out of here fast.
The nothing delivers the comfort and joy like the unrivaled quality and taste of Omaha steaks. It's guaranteed perfection in every single bite. And right now, you can save on unforgivable gifts with 50% off site-wide at omahasteaks.com. Plus, score an extra $30 off with promo code ARMY. A-R-M-Y. With 5 generations of experience, they consistently deliver the world's best steak experience. And the gifting experts at Omaha Steaks have made it easy to deliver the perfect gift with their thoughtfully curated gift packages featuring gourmet favorites. As a matter of fact, I just sent my dad this very same package. From legendary steaks to mouth-watering desserts and more. Save 50% off site-wide for a limited time only at omahasteaks.com. Plus, my listeners get an extra $30 off with promo code ARMY. That's 50% off at omahasteaks.com. OMAHA steaks.com. And an extra $30 off with promo code ARMY. Minimum purchase may apply.